we've had a very major development taking place here with huge land order apprehensions. But I'm happy to say that our people in the state, both in Jammu region, Kashmir region, and also in Leh, Kargil, have been very, very cooperative. And our maintenance of land order in the state, erstwhile state of Jammu and Kashmir, which is still a state till the UT is finally functional, has been very good. Despite a number of land order incidents reported from various places in the state, there was hardly any serious land order engagement. Very minor kind of incidents took place in most of the places. Till yesterday, 184 incidents of land order engagements were there, of which not more than half a dozen of our such a nature were a little higher level of violence was seen in terms of stone pelting by the civilians. We have also from the police and the forces side tried to exercise lot of restraint, and a very minimal use of force has been exercised wherever required, and that is why our casualties on the civilian side have been absolutely nil, barring an incident wherein a stone pelter got injured in downtown and he subsequently succumbed to his injuries. On the contrary, we have had incidents where stone pelters caused injuries to the civilians and also caused a civilian death in Bijbehara, wherein a truck driver got injured in stone pelting and subsequently succumbed to his injuries. We have also had incidents where five civilians were injured in the stone pelting by the stone pelters, which is very, very unfortunate. During this period, we have militancy-related killings by militants. Three persons have been killed by militants, two in Thral area, the Gujar brothers who are somewhere on the Thral heights, on their dohoks, taking care of the cattle. Militants kidnapped them and then killed both of them. Other than that, a shopkeeper in a city here in Paranpura was killed for not abiding the dictates of the militants. So those are three killings by the militants. During this period, two militants have also been neutralized. Earlier, one was killed at Baramulla downtown, and today in another incident, one more militant has been killed. Now I come to today's incident. This fellow, this militant of Lashkar-e-Toyba, Asif Maqbool Bhatt, who has been killed today, he had created a lot of terror in that area, general area of Sopore. Over the last 1 month, he was very active. He is the one who was responsible for making use of OGWs to print and publish posters threatening people not to do the fruit business, not to go for trading, not to open shops and all, not to go for normal day-to-day activities. And we were watching those activities. We were after these people who were involved in this. And you are aware that 8 people who were indulging in this kind of activities were apprehended by Sopore police along with the computers and the other instruments that they were using for printing those threatening letters and pasting them at various locations. This fellow, along with two other militants, Sajad and Mudassar, this fellow is Asif, three of them created terror in that area. They were roaming around in the villages, going to the people, threatening them, telling them not to go for their daily course, not to tend to their business and their normal life. So we were following him, tracking him. Today morning, on a specific information, our police along with SF had laid certain nakas close to Sopore town, and while the fellow came, he was challenged to stop. He did not. He threw a grenade on our party in which a couple of our police personnel are injured, but they are out of danger. In the ensuing encounter, that militant has been neutralized. He is the same militant who has gone to the house of Haji Hamidullah, fired at the family members of Haji Hamidullah, injured four of them, including a small little girl, 4 to 7 years old, who is admitted here in the hospital. Others also were evacuated to this place. He is the same militant who, along with his associates, went to somebody's house where a migrant labor was working, shot at him and injured him. Shafi Alam is his name. That boy was seriously injured. He was brought to Srinagar, and from there he's been treated now, and I'm told he's okay and he's likely to be discharged any moment. So this person was very, very active in Sopor belt, and with his killing today in the morning at around 9 a.m., I believe the area will heave a sigh of the relief, and that terror which he was creating there would be taken care of to some extent. We also know his other two associates. We are after them, and we'll see that in the near future we'll take care of them also.